Hello, I'm Hervé Jeanne. Thanks for joining me for this video on the String Metrics channel. As some of you may know, I'm not only a bass player and a string tester, I also run a recording studio. And as such, I'm always interested in testing different microphones on the same source. So for today's video, I decided to compare 10 dynamic microphones to be used on the double bass. This is going to be a blindfold test, and I would recommend that you use good headphones to hear all the slight differences. Dynamic microphones aren't typically the type of microphones that you would use in the studio when recording the double bass. Mostly you would use a condenser microphone. But there are some situations where it may be a good idea to use a dynamic microphone. For instance, if you are with the whole band in one room and you want to reduce the bleed, or you may want to use a dynamic just as a complementary or alternative microphone to a condenser microphone. So I'm quickly going to show you which microphones I have here. I have two microphones by Shure. This one is probably the most famous instrumental microphone, the SM57. Then I have this one here, the SM7 by Shure. It's originally a broadcast microphone, but it has been used for a lot of things, bass drum, horns, and even for vocals. The vocals of Michael Jackson have been recorded on this microphone on some records. So the microphone that I'm using in this test is the original SM7, not the SM7B that you can buy in the shops right now. At first, I thought that there was absolutely no sonic difference between those two microphones, but then I did some research and found out that there is a little difference. The response in the high frequencies is a little different, and I thought that also the mids sound a little different on acoustic instruments. If you want to know more about this, you can check the internet. There are some nice videos about the differences between those two mics. Then we have this one here, which is also used as a broadcast microphone sometimes, but also used on horns and a lot of other things. It's the Electro Voice RE20. Then I have this one here, it's the Baya M201. It's a great instrumental microphone. Actually, it's not as well known as some other models, although it should be. So I'm very curious to hear the sound of this one. Then I have three microphones by AKG. This one here is actually a vocal microphone. I was very impressed by this microphone on vocals some days ago. It's the model D5. And it's a hypercardioid microphone, so I thought I will give it a try on the double bass. Then I have this one here, it's the AKG D3500. We mostly use this one for tom-toms. Then I have this one here, it's the AKG D12. It's very famous as a bass drum microphone, but I heard that it has also been used as a vocal microphone. And then I have some microphones by Sennheiser. This one here, MD421. It's probably the most famous German dynamic microphone. You've seen it everywhere on every kind of instruments and in front of politicians, everything. And this one here is a very appreciated microphone by Sennheiser. It's the MD441. It's a hypercardioid. And the 10th microphone is this one here, the one I'm talking through. This one is a little bit special because it's an omni microphone. So if you're trying to reduce bleed when you're playing together with other instruments, it will not be a good idea to use this one because it will record the sound all around the mic. But still, I wanted to hear what it sounds like on the double bass. So the first thing that I want to try is to try different positions for the microphone. I will use the Baya for this test. And now it's exactly in the position that I normally use when I'm in the studio. The microphone is 15 centimeter from the strings. It's pointing somewhere between the bridge and the end of the neck, maybe a little lower than the middle, and it's basically horizontal and facing really straight to the top of the bass. My next test will be the same, just a little bit higher. Next, the same thing, lower. Now the microphone is facing just under the bridge. Now I'm back in the first position, but I will shift the stand so that it shows just to a point between the bridge and the F hole. And next I will try to put the microphone really showing to the F hole and a little bit closer to the bass. And now back to the basic position. This is the basic position that I use mostly when I'm in the studio. Okay, so we are ready to start the shootout. I'm going to do it the following way. You will not see the microphones and you will not see the name of the microphone. I want you to only listen to the sound. Each microphone gets a number, and maybe you want to take notes and write down your observations and what you like, what you dislike. And later in the video, I'm going to tell you which number was which microphone. When you are listening to these microphones and you're taking your notes, don't listen only to the sound itself, but pay attention to the way the sound is in different ranges of the bass, because some mics may have some notes sticking out or some notes being very fat and others being more thin or nasal. And this is a very important aspect, I think, that the microphone that you use will sound nice in all parts of the range of your instrument. This is the way I always do my tests in the studio, because if you know what you're listening to, your brain is going to tell you you have to find this piece of equipment great because it is the model so-and-so, which is very expensive or very famous or whatever. But if you don't know what you're listening to, maybe a microphone that's absolutely not famous or expensive is going to turn out as the one that you like the most. Okay, so let's start. Microphone number one. Microphone number two. Microphone number three. Microphone number four. Microphone number five. Microphone number six. Microphone microphone number 7. Microphone number 8. Microphone number 9. Microphone number 10. Okay, so this was round one. We're going to listen again to all 10 mics, starting now from number 10 and going down to number 1. And I'm going to play a different phrase just to give you one more impression. So, you're ready for the results. Here they are. Number 1 was the AKG D5. Number 2 was the Shure SM57. Number 3 was the Bayer 201. Number 4 was the Electro Voice RE20. Number 5 was this one here, the one I'm talking through, the Sennheiser MD21. Number 6 was again Sennheiser, the MD441. Number 7 was this one here, the AKG D3500. Number 8 was the Sennheiser MD421. Number 9 was the AKG D12. And finally, number 10 was this one here. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. The next thing I'm planning to do is a shootout for condenser microphones. If you have any suggestion, if you would like me to play a little bit longer my phrases or whatever, let me know in the comments. And also let me know what you thought of these microphones, which ones were your favorites and why. I'm really curious to read about this in the comments. And for those who didn't subscribe to my channel yet, please do that right away so you won't miss the upcoming tests. We will have the condenser test, and I want to do a new clip microphone test. I already had an old video about this, but I want to do a new one. And maybe I will also make a ribbon test. So if you don't want to miss any of these, hit the subscribe button. Okay, that's it for today. See you very soon. Bye-bye.